In this illustration, we'll study about photon density in sunlight on Earth's surface. Here we are given, when sun is directly overhead, the surface of Earth receives 1.4 kilowatt per meter square intensity of sunlight. And it is saying, assuming sunlight is monochromatic of wavelength 5000 angstrom, directly coming from sun, with Earth sun distance given here, we are required to calculate the photon density in sunlight near Earth's surface and number of photons emitted by sun per second. Here we can recall that in concept videos we have studied about photon density, of which the expression is given as rho is equals to I lambda by hc square photons per meter cube. For a light from sun, if we talk at a distance r, say if this earth, so light from sun is radiated in all directions, and the light which incident on earth will be on the surface of a sphere of radius r on which the earth is orbiting. So here we can write the value of number of photons emitted by sun is equals to number of photons falling per meter square on area of Earth multiplied by the area of this hypothetical sphere on the surface of which Earth is located, or the sphere in which Earth orbit is existing. Here we can write, if photon density is this, we can simply calculate the numerical value. Here we can calculate the value of intensity of sunlight, which is given as 1.4 kilowatt per meter square. This is 1.4 into 10 to power 3 multiplied by the wavelength is 5000 angstrom, which is 5 into 10 to power minus 7 divided by h is 6.63 into 10 to power minus 34. Multiplied by 3 into 10 to power 8 whole square. On simplifying this, it will give us 1.17 into 10 to power 13 photons per meter cube. That is the result of the photon density. If we calculate the total number of photons, emitted by sun, then here we can write total number of photons will be photon density rho, which is the number of photons per meter cube incident on it. If we multiply it by c, again it gives the number of photons per second. And this should be multiplied by the total area of this spherical, hypothetical spherical surface of radius r with center at sun, what we discussed just now. So here we can write number of photons per second per meter square on earth multiplied by 4 pi r square. So in this situation, this can be written as I lambda by hc, number of photons per second per meter square. So this will give us number of photons emitted by sun per second, that is equals to 1.4 into 10 to power 3 multiplied by 5 into 10 to power minus 7 divided by 6.63 into 10 to power minus 34. Multiplied by 3 into 10 to power 8. So these are the number of photons per second per meter square. This we multiplied by 4 pi r square. On substituting the value of this distance, if you simplify this value, it gives us 9.94 into 10 to power 44 photons per second. That will be the result of this problem.